Trump's remaining rival for the Republican nomination, Nikki Haley, vowing to stay in the race. She urged voters in Vermont to support her in Tuesday's primary in a speech that was frequently interrupted by hecklers. Despite performing well with moderate voters, the former South Carolina governor has no clear path to beating Trump, and Super Tuesday could be her last chance to slow the former president's path to the nomination.
The media has been like all over themselves trying to figure out why I'm not getting out of this race. Why does she keep fighting? What's she doing? Well, first of all, when 70% of Americans say they don't want Donald Trump or Joe Biden, yes, I'm going to keep on fighting.
Relatives and friends remember the passengers of the doomed Malaysia Airlines flight MH370. The plane vanished 10 years ago en route from Kuala Lumpur to Beijing, with 239 people on board in one of the world's largest aviation mysteries. Debris, some confirmed and some believed to be part from the aircraft, have washed up along the coast of Africa and islands in the Indian Ocean. In January 2017, Malaysia, China, and Australia ended a fruitless $130 million hunt. But at a remembrance event in Subang Jaya, Malaysia's transport minister says the government is pushing for a renewed search for the plane.
As I've mentioned numerous times, as far as Malaysian government is concerned, we are committed to that search, and the search must go on.
French lawmakers meet Monday to hold a final vote on inscribing abortion into the Constitution in a move widely expected to pass. French President Emmanuel Macron convened a special Congress of National Assembly representatives and senators in Versailles. If the proposition garners a 3/5 of majority, France will become the world's first nation to constitutionalize abortion. Women have had a legal right to abortion in France since a law was adopted in 1974. A women's rights group says France's historic decision is a message to other countries with less progressive abortion laws to follow suit. Now let's find out what stories our North America Bureau is pursuing right now from our correspondent, Henny Espinosa.
Hey guys, here are news making headlines for Filipinos in North America.
We begin in Southern California, where a Filipino-American lawyer hopes to become the next U.S. congressman. California's primary election is on March 5th, and Phil M. Kurt Jose is making a last-ditch effort to win votes in California's 31st district, which encompasses the San Gabriel Valley and includes the cities of Azusa, Baldwin Park, Bradbury, Covina, Duarte, El Monte, Irwindale, La Puente, La Verne, San Dimas, South El Monte, and West Covina, and portions of Glendora, Industry, and Monrovia. The district's longtime incumbent, Democratic Representative Grace Napolitano, announced her retirement last summer. 10 candidates are vying for her seat, including Jose. The top two candidates will advance to the general election in November. Jose, an Oxford University alumnus, joined other candidates at the recent forums hosted by the San Gabriel Valley Public Affairs Network and the Veterans Affiliated Council. If he wins, Jose, a healthcare advocate and cybersecurity expert, could be the third Filipino to hold a U.S. congressional seat after Bobby Scott of Virginia and T.J. Cox of California.
My focus is on solutions that are tangible and that I can act on from day one, and not giving you promises that can come later in 2 years. My goal is helping you now and taking care of the problems you worry about every day. So the reason I want you to vote me on March 5th is because I'm about unification. We're not red or blue. We're red, white, and blue, and we're American, and I want to bring that spirit back to Congress.
We go to San Mateo County in Northern California, where election officials are making voting much more accessible to its immigrant communities. They are particularly reaching out to eligible Filipino voters, informing them of the different ways they can cast their ballots, and with an option to get all voting materials in Tagalog.
We make an extra effort to make sure that we're multilingual and that that information is printed, like the sample ballot, the voter information pamphlet, is in Filipino. But we also have materials that go out to the Filipino press, media, brochures, all written in the language. And our website also is multilingual.
Irizarry says San Mateo County seeks to provide more ways and more days to vote. In fact, while the California primary election is on March 5th, voting in San Mateo County actually started on February 5th, when all 434,000 registered voters received their official ballots by mail.
We make it extremely easy and convenient for everyone to cast a ballot, whether it's by mail, to drop it off at a drop box, to go to a vote center to vote in person, and to also vote electronically.
Irizarry has these reminders for those casting their ballots on Super Tuesday.
The polls will open at 7 a.m. in the morning and they will close at 8 p.m. in the evening. Anyone that is in line prior to 8 p.m. will be able to vote. If you mail your ballot, you need to make sure that it's postmarked with a date before March 5th and that we receive it before midnight on Election Day.
And those are the news making headlines today. You can catch more TFC News on the ABS-CBN News website, YouTube channel, and app. I'm Henny Espinosa. Back to you guys at the Rundown.